Starting with the seventh problem, we'll represent the data after reading the problem as per the master diagram. A line PQ 110 mm long has its plan and elevation lengths 80 mm and 90 mm. Means from the master diagram, I know true length, plan length means top view length, and elevation means front view length. But here the notations given for the line are PQ, but our master diagram we are drawn assuming AB as the line. So now here, while writing the notations, we will replace A by P and Q by B by Q. So I'll write the data. 110 mm is the true length. So from the data, A dash, B1 dash and AB2. So I'll write in terms of P and Q. So I'll write P dash Q1 dash is equal to PQ2 is equal to 110 mm. Now the plan length is 80 mm. So plan length notation is AB1, which is equal to the top view. So I'll get AB1 equal to AB. So in terms of PQ, I can write PQ1 is equal to PQ is equal to 80 mm. And elevation length is 90 mm, which is the front view. So the notations are A dash, B dash and AB2 dash. So in terms of PQ, I can write P dash Q2 dash is equal to P dash Q dash is equal to 90 mm. One end of the line P is in HP. As I know, if the point is lying on the HP, its front view will be on the XY line. It will coincide with the XY line. So I can write front view for P, which is P dash on XY. It is not either below or above XY. So it is on XY line. And the other end Q in the VP. So obviously we know if the point is in the VP, its top view will lie on the XY line. So the notation for top view for Q is without dash. So Q again on the XY, since it is lying in the VP. Assume the line in the third quadrant. That means if the line is in third quadrant, both the endpoints P and Q will be in third quadrant. It will be exact reverse of this. So we already got the position of P dash on XY. So for top view, which is the position P comparing with A, since it is in third quadrant, for first quadrant it is below XY. So in this case, P will be above XY because line is in third quadrant. So P is above XY. The top view of P will be above XY. Similarly, for point Q, top view position is already on the XY. So now, depending on the quadrant, I need to decide the front view position of Q dash. That means here the first quadrant Q dash, the B dash is above XY. So similarly for third quadrant, it will come below. So here the Q dash will be below XY since it is in third quadrant. Now draw the projections of the line and find its inclination with the HP and VP. So we need to find theta and phi. Now here there are some chances of confusion due to change in notations. Here we are having PQ instead of AB, and the points are lying that's front view is lying on the XY and top view of Q is lying on the XY. So we'll start with the solution. Again, starting with the reference line. Again, the line is entirely lying on the in the third quadrant. So solution will be both above and below XY line. So I'll start somewhere in the middle. Okay. Now we'll start with point P dash, which is the front view of point P, which is lying on the XY. So I can randomly mark anywhere on the XY line P dash. okay. Q is also on the xy line, but I don't know the exact position, so we'll see how to get Q later on. Now P is above xy, but I don't know how much distance, so I right now I can't mark P also and Q dash also. So with this I need to start from P dash. So starting with P dash, only thing I can mark is elevation length, okay, which is P dash Q2 dash, and that is given as P dash Q2 dash is 90 mm. So along the xy line I can mark elevation length P dash Q2 dash, which is 90 mm. So this point will give me Q2 dash. Now as it is given that Q is on the xy, so from B2 dash we are getting Q2 on the locus of B, but here since Q is on the xy, this xy line itself will become locus of Q. Okay, so from Q2 dash here we need to project the line, a vertical project line up to locus of B to get B2, but here Q2 dash is already lying on locus of Q. So here Q, like B2 dash and B2, the Q2 dash and Q2 will coincide. That means the same point will give me Q2 also, because there is no need to project on up to locus of Q, because xy line itself is locus of Q as point Q is lying on the xy line. Now moving to the next step, now we have marked point Q2, which is B2 in the master diagram. So from B2 I can now measure true length, which is AB2. So true length is given, which is 110 mm. So I need to mark now PQ2. For that we have got point Q2, and we know P is obviously going to lie on a vertical projector, because initially the position of P was not given, only P dash was lying on the xy. So now we are going in the reverse direction. So I know P is going to lie on the on this vertical projector, and we know since P is in the third quadrant, the top view of P will be above xy. So with Q2 I can take distance equal to true length, which is PQ2, 110 mm. With Q2 I can cut an arc on this vertical projector to mark point P, because P is above xy, but that distance was not given, so we can't mark it initially. So we are going in reverse direction to mark point P. Now after P, which is similar to A here, I can now mark a plan length on a horizontal line from A. That means here I can mark plan length from a horizontal line passing through P. So from P I'll draw a horizontal line, and on this line I can mark the plan length, which is 80 mm, and the point which I'll get is PQ1. So plan length PQ1, again mark 80 mm distance. So I'm getting this point as Q1. So this is plan length, and this is P dash Q2 dash is elevation length. So we have marked plan length and elevation length. Now moving further from Q1, which is the point here, I have to produce an arc up to locus of B. That means from plan length, if I produce an arc up to locus of B, here it is point Q, so I have to produce an arc up to locus of Q. So with plan length PQ1, will produce up to locus of Q, which is nothing but the xy line, and that point will give me the final top U. Here it is point Q. Okay, so using plan length, we have marked the required top U, which is the PQ. Okay. Now, with Q1, we can also draw the true length. Okay, so from Q1, here it is point B1. If I am dropping a vertical projector on the same line, we are going to get B1 dash. That means in this case Q1 dash, and we know position of A dash. So here it is P dash. So from P dash, we can mark the true length P dash Q1 dash on a vertical projector from Q1. So from Q1, we are dropping a vertical projector. Be careful while drawing the parallel lines. So from Q1, we are dropping a vertical projector. On that vertical projector, we are going to mark the true length P dash Q1 dash, which is again 110. So I'm going to measure that distance 110 mm. And with P dash as a center, I need to cut the arc on that vertical projector from Q1 to get Q1 dash. So I need to produce this further. So this point will be Q1 dash. Now after joining P dash Q1 dash, I'll get the true length in front view. And from Q1 dash, I can draw locus of Q dash. So here I got locus of Q dash, and we know that Q dash is below xy. That's why we are getting locus of Q dash below xy. Now the last thing remaining is marking the position of Q dash and marking the true length in top U, that is PQ1, PQ2. Okay. So for marking A dash B dash, that means P dash Q dash, I need to produce this elevation length up to locus of B dash. That means here in this case locus of Q dash. So I'll take elevation length P dash Q2 dash, and I'll produce that length up to locus of Q dash. So I'll get final location for front view, that is P dash Q dash. So I'll get this length P dash Q dash. Okay. Now we have marked P dash Q dash and PQ. The only thing remaining is true length in top view, that is PQ2. So for that, I'll again take the true length, which is 110 mm, which is already marked in front view. The same length we have to mark in top view. So with P as a center, I have to mark PQ2. Now I know the locus of Q is here, so I'll get Q on the same locus, so which is already marked, because Q2 dash, the projector is coinciding with XY line. So those are the identical points, Q2 dash and Q. So I can just join PQ2 to get the true length in top view. So my final answer is top view P dash Q, sorry, top view PQ. I need to make it dark, and P dash Q dash. Now we need to find theta and phi here. So theta is the angle made by P dash Q1 dash, that is the true length. I'll first write the notations true length. Then P dash Q dash is front view. Then PQ2 is again true length in top view. And PQ is actual top view. Now we need to measure the angles made by true length. So theta is with the HP and phi is with the VP. So we need to measure theta and phi, which are the required answers. So before that, we will check whether your solution is right or wrong. So for that, we will check whether Q dash and Q are passing through a same vertical projector. Some minute error is acceptable. Here we are getting some error, but since the angles are large and lengths are also large, that much error is acceptable. So now we will measure theta and phi, which are the required answers. So theta is angle made by P dash Q1 dash. Here I am getting it as 42. Again, plus minus 1 degree is acceptable. Then for phi, I need to measure angle made by PQ2 with the horizontal. So it is almost 29 degrees, 34 degrees. Again, plus minus 1 degree is acceptable. So this completes the solution for this problem. Bit tricky due to change in notations, and the data is not a usual data compared to the previous problems. So this completes the solution for this problem.